Many times you may heard that Java is a platform independent language. But how? In this last video of session 1, I am going to answer this question. Hello everyone, I am Gyan and you are watching the last video of first session of Java and Web, installation and first program. Java has both compiler and interpreter. We invoke compiler as command Java C and interpreter as command Java. Java interpreter is actually a virtual machine called Java Virtual Machine or JVM. But what is a virtual machine? To understand that, we need to understand what the actual machines are. We consider our computer as an actual physical machine which has different hardware working together. For example, we have memory, RAM, we have hard disk, we have processor, etc. Our computer has one or more processors. These processors understand a fixed set of binary instructions called machine instructions. C or C++ compilers actually convert our codes into a set of instructions which is directly understandable by our actual or physical machine. Here I am running Windows Guest on Ubuntu host. This is my Windows Guest and this is Ubuntu host. The Ubuntu host with my laptop hardware combinedly called actual machine. But the VirtualBox is running as a process on my actual machine. This VirtualBox has software simulation for processor, memory, hard disk drive, etc. In fact, VirtualBox is the complete software simulation of a computer. VirtualBox is not an actual computer. VirtualBox uses actual machine for its work. You can see here, this is my guest machine. And if we go in the VirtualBox control panel, we can see that we have everything virtually implemented here. We have virtual storage, we have virtual display. If you click here, we have virtual motherboard, virtual processor, virtual storage, virtual display. So this guest has everything virtually, but this guest is not the actual machine. This guest is virtual machine running here. If we are running a program in our guest machine, the program will create a binary instructions to the guest machine. And then after, the guest machine as a software will create a new machine instruction code for the host machine. And ultimately all the programs running in the guest machine will create the machine instruction for the host machine only. The host machine is the actual and physical machine and the guest machine is inside the virtual box. Now what the virtual machine is? Virtual machine is a software installed on the actual machine. We can install a program on our actual machine which can act itself as a machine. Example, VirtualBox or VMware, etc. This installed machine is called virtual machine. Virtual machine can have its own set of virtual hardware. Processors in virtual machine may understand a set of instructions other than the actual machine on which it has been installed. We can call actual machine as a host and virtual machine as a guest. Ultimately, everything will be get converted in the instructions for host machine only. There are two types of virtual machine. First one is hardware based, also called system based. And second one is application based, also called process based. The hardware based virtual machine shares hardware with various strongly isolated system. For example, you can see here, I have two systems installed in it, Windows 7 and Ubuntu. And this is another host Ubuntu. So in all, I have three systems installed on the same hardware. All the three are using the same hardware. In fact, they are sharing the same hardware, but they are strongly isolated. These machines are called hardware-based machine, shares hardware with various strongly isolated systems. For example, VMware, VirtualBox, Xen, KVM, etc. Other type of virtual machine is application-based or process-based virtual machine. They provide runtime engines for programming languages. Example of application-based virtual machines are JVM, PVM, CLR, etc. Using JVM, we run Java bytecode. Using PVM, we run Perl-based applications. And using CLR, we run .NET-based applications. Let's see how JVM works. We have first.java code and we pass this first.java code to the Java compiler using Java C command. Java C compiler compiles it and creates a bytecode. The bytecode is the machine instructions for the JVM, not for the actual machine. Save it on the hard disk with the name of first.class. Now we have to pass it to JVM. The JVM has its own memory, own machine instructions, and the bytecode is the machine instructions for the JVM, not for the actual machine. Remember that this bytecode is machine instructions for JVM. This bytecode is not a machine instruction for the actual machine on which you are running Java. We pass this bytecode to the JVM. JVM interpret this bytecode line by line and create machine instructions for actual machine. Operating system pass this machine instruction code for actual machine to the CPU, and CPU execute the machine instruction code for actual machine and show output on the screen. This is how Java virtual machine works. Now the ultimate question, how the Java is platform independent? We have installed Windows based JVM on the Windows machine, Linux based JVM on the Linux machine, Mac based JVM on the Mac machine. These JVMs are different for different machines. Then after we have source code first.java. We have to compile our source code with Java C compiler. The Java C creates the bytecode from the source code first.java, and this bytecode can be run separately on all the three JVM. Doesn't matter JVM installed in what machine, the bytecode is same for all JVM. That's how we can run same bytecode on the all machines. Doesn't matter it is a Windows machine or Linux machine or Mac machine, because we do not have to run it directly on Windows, Linux or Mac. We have to run it on the JVM. On the other hand, the executable file generated by C or C++ compiler on Windows machine cannot be run on the Linux machine. And executable file generated by C or C++ compiler for the Linux machine cannot be run on the Windows machine. But the case is different for Java. The created bytecode by Java compiler can be run anywhere because it do not has to run on different machines. It has to run on the JVM only. We come to the end of session 1. Thanks for watching. See you in the next session. Variables, data types and operators. Thank you.